Welcome. Very short video today. I'm just going to show you one little package that I find very interesting. It's not a package that is only released on GitHub, so this is a package that is available on CRAN, or CRAN, I think you should say. And usually for this type of videos, I always try to focus on the functions that are not very well known, and that's usually packages that are only released on GitHub. But in this case, it's one that is released on CRAN that I think is quite useful and probably not very well known. So this is a typical dplyr workflow, right? So you have some data, you do some stuff on it. So the first one, I'm just filtering out HP, and then I'm grouping by AM, and then I'm running a summary. And then I do something similar. I just select some columns, and I just keep the automatic cars, right? Now, imagine that you have a very, very long script with a lot of calls like that. You might lose track of what is happening, especially with filters. I find, especially when I'm doing this kind of stuff, it's really the filters that I would really like to know how many rows get eliminated, right, with each filter. There's a package called tidylog. So let's load it. What tidylog does is that it, as you see, it masks a lot of functions, not all functions. And as you can see, it still uses this deprecated, I think, dplyr verbs, so group by all, group by at, group by if, filter if, etc. Now this is this has been deprecated with across, so you in favor of across, so you use the across function, but you can still use that if you do. But it masks a lot of functions, and what it does, it simply replaces these functions with functions that are very loud, in a sense. They yell at your face and they tell you what they're doing. There's also some functions from tidyverse that get replaced. Let's see what happens now that we run the code. So I'm a bit sick because of, I don't know how you call that in English, but this pollen sickness thing, it's hell. Anyway, my filter removes 16 rows exactly. Actually, that was this filter was totally random, but it removes 60% of the rows. I group by one variable, so that's pretty clear. The group by calls in general are not so problematic. And then I do this summary, and I get two rows, two columns, and it's ungrouped. So this is pretty useful that it tells you that it's ungrouped, because sometimes if you group by more than one variable, it just ungroups. It keeps one level, right? So as you see, still grouping by one variable. So actually that's pretty useful as well. And that's it, you know, you get this this very useful and helpful messages, logs, that allow you to understand what is going on. This is especially useful, I find, when I'm working with a new data set that I don't know. I like to try some things. I like to try some filters, again, especially filters. I think this is really useful. So it's called tidylog. As I said, not everything is implemented. For example, across is not implemented, but you can use these other functions if you have the need to use across. You could use that just to see what's happening. And yeah, I find it very useful. There's some other packages like that that are only released on GitHub, called, I think it's called, they're both called safe join. I might talk about them, but as the name implies, they're really focused on joins. Oh, by the way, let me try a join. Let me just join like empty cars on empty cars, and you'll see what's going to happen. Maybe just, you know, by one variable. This is also very useful because it also tells you what's happening. So now, of course, we have the whole, it wasn't very smart of me. Maybe let me save that somewhere here, like empty cars too. And we should be able to see. So now you get this, again, very, very helpful messages. So rows that are only in X, so X being your left-hand side data set, so this empty cars, and then Y being your right-hand side data set. And then, you know, what is matched, what is the total, etc. So this is really useful. Again, you get these very neat and helpful error messages, or not error messages, but logs, you know, just what is going on. Very useful with filters and with joins, I find. But also, again, very useful with summary statistics, because again, you get this helpful message that sometimes I forget that the dataset remains grouped. So it's really nice to have this if you are in an exploratory phase. Then, of course, if you're writing code that is supposed to run in production through, you know, through some CRAN jobs or whatever, then, of course, it's not that useful. But I wonder, now that I'm saying that, if there probably is a way to capture these messages and have them in a sort of log that you could then just read once your script is done running. This probably works, especially with Knitter. So if you knit the method, if you knit your script, you could probably save a text file with all these logs, and that's pretty useful, I guess. So you could then get an automatic email, for example, and read and see if something went wrong. Pretty useful stuff. So I hope you enjoyed. And it's Mother's Day in my country, so happy Mother's Day to any mother watching this video. Have a good one, and stay safe.